Hi, guys. Thank you for joining me. I hope you're enjoying your day. Yesterday, at about 5:28 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.1 earthquake there along the Juan De Fuca fault zone. Two people reportedly felt this earthquake, and they listed it as 10 kilometers in depth, which they often do when they don't really know how deep the earthquake is. On the felt reports, there was one report from Redmond, close to Bend. Let me show you this here. Right there. And supposedly it was an intensity level of 2, which according to the modified Mercalli scale, intensity level means that it's felt by a few persons who are resting, either sitting or laying down. Especially on the upper floors of buildings. Delicate suspended objects may swing. A lot of people probably wondered if there was an earthquake, and maybe if they looked up and saw plants or lights gently swaying, then they probably knew that there was an earthquake. And only two people reportedly felt this earthquake. Going to Google Earth, here you can see we got the Juan De Fuca plate, which is subducting underneath the North American plate. Here we got the Cascadia subduction zone, and it's a little concerning how close this earthquake is to the Cascadia subduction zone, seeing how certain areas it's locked and ready for a major earthquake. So I thought I would look up for quiet earthquakes. For the 16th, there was 10. And most of them in the Washington area. Okay, for the next day, which would have been yesterday, there was no earthquakes whatsoever anywhere along the west coast of Washington, Oregon, and down here at the Mendocino Triple Junction. No earthquakes whatsoever. Today, the 18th, they won't show how many earthquakes have occurred until the end of the day, and they'll post that tomorrow. But no earthquakes whatsoever. It's a little concerning. Yeah, this earthquake was caused by the subduction, like I said, this landmass going underneath the Cascadia fault zone under the North American plate. The Juan De Fuca plate is a remnant of the Farallon plate. Here we have an image from USGS showing the Juan De Fuca plate subducting underneath the North American plate. Some of you might find this interesting. There is an area not far from here called the Hydrate Ridge. It is an acceleration thrust Cothrate hydrate formation, meaning it has been made of sediment scraped off of subducting oceanic plate. It is approximately 700 feet high and located 100 kilometers, 62 miles offshore of Oregon. The hydrate formation, methane, is trapped in crystallized water structures. Southern Hydrate Ridge, located about 90 kilometers offshore of Oregon coast, is an active methane seep site located on the southern portion of the Hydrate Ridge. This is also called burning ice. Gas hydrates are ice-like crystalline structure composed of hydrogen-bounded water molecules encapsulating gas molecules. They're also known as burning ice. Their deposits are so huge that they gain the attention of alternative energy. From the energy resource point of view, the enormous amount of methane hydrate under the ocean and beneath the Arctic permafrost represents an estimated 53% of all fossil fuel, coal, oil, and natural gas reserves on Earth. They are of considerable interest for their potential as an energy source and for their potential role in global climate change. So I thought that was real interesting when I found that area off the coast there of Newport. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of locked up methane in that location. Yeah, and another term is burning ice. But anyways, Yeah, going back to this earthquake, how deep was it really? To truly figure it out, they need to triangulate the earthquake, which they can't do because they don't have monitors off the coast to do that. And they need three different monitors in the shape of a triangle. So, yeah, they'd probably just be guessing. That's why they put 10 kilometers in depth, because they really don't know how deep that earthquake was there. And because of the difficulty of triangulation of the earthquake, it might not have been right where they're saying it was. Yeah, they're just taking monitors off the coast to see, you know, what they had there. They don't have one out here in the ocean. I have access to one earthquake monitoring station right there by Corvallis. And here is an image of that earthquake as it came in. And I'll show you the spectrogram. I don't know if you can see it here. This is Coos Bay, Oregon. And this is the signature of the 3.1. They also have another one here. I don't know. It's not listed. And then there's some other little stuff that's gone on that shows up here. And then for those of you that are monitoring the different volcanoes in the area, this one here is for Crater Lake. Everything looks pretty good right now. Again, this is Crater Lake, Oregon. And this is for Newberry. Yeah, let's check that one out right there. Let's see what was going on there. Got some data missing. Yeah, I wanted to see what that was, but it won't let me view it. See, it looks all pretty good. And Three Sisters. This signature normally is from rock slides. Yeah, but there is harmonic tremors up here, but I don't see no magma. I mean, there is gases coming up, but I don't see anything hot like magma for recharging. And here we have Mount Hood. See, this is, let me go back. This is at the top. It's not coming up from the bottom. Now, they do have gases coming up. Yeah, they do have gases coming up. I'll click on this one here and show you. See that? This is not volcanic. This is where they're adjusting their machinery, their equipment. So everything looks okay there. All right, Mount St. Helens. Let's see what's going on with there. Let's click on that. Again, that came from the top. Let's take a look at that. And we'll pull it down a little bit more. See if we see anything really going on. Nothing really going on at Mount St. Helens either. All right, Mount Rainier. Now that's a little more concerning when you see stuff like that. See, it's coming up from the bottom. Yeah. All right, the monitoring for Mount Rainier. We got, a magnitude 1 supposedly, depth of 0.6 miles. Let's see, that was on the 3rd. We got another small one on the 2nd, a 0.7. 1.2 miles. That was a magnitude 1.2. All right, what else we got? That's gonna let me click on here or not. Yeah, it's not gonna do it. Okay, a 0.6. That was last month on the 21st. On the 19th, a 0.8. Now it's along the rim. Yeah, maybe I should keep an eye on Mount Rainier besides Yellowstone, right? Now you can see here, these are volcanic earthquakes. You know, it distinguishes between tectonic. I'll change that. Oh, it switched to Mount Baker. Going back. All right, going back to Mount Rainier. I don't know how that happened, but yeah. Look at that. It's definitely recharging. Yep. Yep. See, and this is what's called blobs of magma that's coming in. So it is recharging. And this is the different time. Let me bring it over so you can see it. This is all from today. Okay. Yeah. And then it settled down. See, that's up at the top. That's at the bottom. 12 o'clock. Oh, this is when they were adjusting their machine. All right. Adjusting the data. Okay. Well, it was pretty active earlier. 1600, 1700. Yeah, maybe I should start keeping an eye on Mount Rainier. See, this is the stuff that Yellowstone was showing. Yeah, about 2 weeks ago. Yeah. And these are volcanic earthquakes. Yeah. All right, let me go. Let me see if it's going to do it right. We'll go to tectonic. Will it stay? Now, see, it's going to the Puget Sound. All right, well, let's see if it's going to show us volcanic for Puget Sound. No, it doesn't. Every time I do that, it changes on me. Yeah. Hmm. Interesting. This is going to end up being a long... I get distracted, switched over to different things. See, what you got to worry about for Mount Rainier, if it ever has an eruption, even a smaller one, you got to worry about Lahars and all these small towns that are in the area where past Lahars have happened. I think I covered that a while back. Let me... All right, down here we got Ashford. And you can see, yeah. And we got Longmire. We got Paradise. Yeah. Down here by the Puget Sound. Yeah, I did a video about that, the danger of Lahars for this area. Yeah. Yeah. It's all coming back to me now. It's been a while. Yeah. I'm going to see if I can find a link to that. But see, this whole area here has been inundated in the past by Lahars, by the eruption of Mount Rainier, and yeah, the mud flows, and yeah, you should have an evacuation plan, yeah, just in case. Much of this area has been developed over, yeah, past areas of Lahars. Yeah, Tacoma, Washington. I mean, yeah, you can tell just by the coloring. Yeah. That other geologist, Nick, he's a teacher there in that area. He did a video, too, about the dangers of past Lahars from Mount Rainier. Yeah. See this? Yeah, it goes all the way down here. Yeah, the mud flows. And it's all been developed. So sometimes, like when I'm doing research and studying about certain fault lines and stuff, I get distracted. Here I started out with this magnitude 3.1 earthquake. off the coast of Oregon, and I ended up at Mount Rainier up here. Everything happens for a reason. Yeah. Now this one, I believe, is a signature. Oh, no, I'm stand corrected. I was going to say it was where they're adjusting their machine, but it's not. Yeah, it's not. Hope you got a plan. I mean, you buy your home and go to work and go to school, and you never think about that volcano that's looming up over you. Just a matter of time. History always repeats itself. So that's about it. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.